My calculations are correct.
I hope so, because then you've got severe issues.
I have a score of 5-5.
You're good. All right. Welcome up, Jeff Fred. You get to choose the next game. What is that game?
New choice.
New choice. The game of new choice. I will blow my whistle, say new choice. They will have to make a new choice. So, let's get a suggestion of a location somewhere you enjoy visiting. Yes, yes, you. Paris, excellent. So, Paris is your suggestion. Paris, this is new choice, are you ready?
Yes!
Begin.
Well, that's the 98th plank. 99 to go.
Pierre! Yeah. The music!
New accent!
Pierre! What do you think you're doing there?
I'm fixing the floor, Jack.
Yeah.
New name!
I'm fixing the floor, Jack.
New name!
I'm fixing the floor, show gal.
Name!
I'm fixing the phlegma, I'm fixing the floor, show gal.
I bought this here property in Paris, Texas. I want to bring my wife here.
Yes, well, you can't bring your wife here when there is a hole in the floor.
New way of entering.
You can't bring your wife here when there's a hole in the floor, Montana.
I will bring my wife when
new
I...
New entrance.
You can't bring your wife around when there's a hole in the floor, Montana. I'm just trying to say.
I'll be there, Melanie.
Yes, you might... Oh, I should address... So my name is Pierre.
Melanie.
Yes, I assume Miss Melanie.
This is Melanie, my foreign wife.
Yes.
Yeah, do you like that hole there, Melanie?
Wow, I sure hope no one were to walk through it.
New joy.
Wow, I sure hope no one throws a bomb up of it.
New joy.
You know, I had this really good Mongolian food earlier.
Sounds delicious, Melanie.
What's delicious?
So, yeah, we're gonna keep the hole. I like it.
There goes the hammer.
Oh, Melanie. Are you okay, dear Mel?
Yeah! New choice.
The Mongolian food!
Somebody touch her! Somebody touch somebody! Help! Help! Help!
Let's call for help.
Yes! This is my health person. He helps me when...
New choice.
This is my surgeon I keep on. Hey.
Oh, so you hired him to fix, to make a hole, and then I try to fix it.
To the shot.
Oh my God. Yeah, so I think this here surgeon, because sometimes I get like these like little put that up to a door and out.
New heart attack. Boom! New heart attack.
You got this foreign wife who can't handle what I'm going through. You have common heart attacks, and right. Your biggest problem is me trying to fix a whore.
I mean, yeah, like it just seems pretty important right now. This floor, like, I have always dealt with these heart attacks. It's just been a lifelong. It's a lifelong struggle. And she, like, I got her like yesterday.
Questions in with good advice, bad advice, and the worst possible advice. Now, let them be the weird ones. Nothing like, oh, I think my dryer is in love with my oven, and now there are a bunch of microwaves all over the place. First off, that wasn't even a question. Secondly, let them be the weird ones. Ask normal questions along the lines of, how do I get a good job? What? How do you ask someone to prom? All that fun stuff. They will be the funny ones. Players, this is good, bad, worse. Are you ready?
Yes.
You have 4 minutes. Begin.
Oh, hello. I didn't see you there. It's me again, Dr. Professor Carlington III. Welcome to Carlington's Corner, where you get your questions answered. Today we have three lovely guests. To answer your questions, guest number one, who are you?
Sup, Chet. You probably don't recognize me. I used to be the captain of the JV lacrosse team. I became a bad boy. I expelled. I don't really show up to school. So.
What a rebel! Number two.
So guys, my name is Marcus. I am the leader of the language department at the Slippery Rock Community College. I teach English. I teach Vietnamese, and I speak part cockroach.
And number three.
Hello, my name is Eustace. I am the world's leading champion in tickling.
I can use a good laugh myself. Well, let's get rid of your questions. Anyone raise your hand? Anyone? I can't see many. Yes, you over there.
Okay, so there's this guy I really like, and he says he really likes me too, but that he doesn't want a relationship. What should I do?
I don't know. Love isn't real to me, but they might have answers. Yes, number one.
So like, I don't really care about feelings and stuff. But like, if I were to care, like, you know, I would like give him space, you know, and like, if the time is right, like, to like you back, like, that would be if I cared, but like, I don't.
Number two?
Alright guys, so when you're like communicating with people, like, communication is key. So, you want to make sure that when you're like talking to them, like in Vietnamese, people go like, there's like a bunch of different tones. So if you're like, hey, do you like me? You'll be like, hey, do you like me? but let's step back a second and like, you want to say like, hey, do you like me? So like, you don't need the tone. So you want to just go flat monotone, like, hey, do you like me? Like, you even go bland, like, hey, you like me?
You chill out. Number three!
Often, I am consumed with giggles. Thus, I tickled to share them with the world. Now, last week, I went to Vegas, and I tickled all the heathens.
All right, then. Another question. Yes, you right there.
What's the best way to study for a test?
Good question. Number one.
I don't really go to school, because like I like wasn't doing well, because like I don't care about school. But if I were to go to school, like I would just say like, you know, really commit to studying because, like, education's the most important thing. And, like, you can go to college and have a happy and successful life, but, like, that's not for me.
So you're not getting a professor by not studying. Number two.
All right, so when you're taking a test, like, it's not usually, like, based off of, like, the textbook. It's more based off of what the professor wants you to know. Like, that's how I run my community college. So pretty much you want to, like, go up to your professor and you're going to, not, like, beat him up, but, like, make sure you know who's boss, and you want to be like, yeah, what do you want to know for the test? Yeah, huh? So, like, make sure he knows that you want to know what you want to know for the test, and you don't want to read the textbook, you throw those away. Those don't even come. Yeah, no, don't order those on Amazon. No. No.
Intimidation is key. And number three!
Often, I wear special tickle gloves at the ends of the fingers to transmit more powerful tickles. Now, when I use these, my tickles are heard around the world.
You know, I may not be a calculus professor. I'm actually very far from it. 2 + 2 is kind of hard. But I think the score is 10-5.
I think you're right. All right. You guys got new captains on the play field. Captain Blue, Captain Red, this is the toss-up game of who has the most X chromosomes in 3, 2, 1. Congratulations, Captain. Next time. So, you get to choose to close this out. What is that game?
Beastie Rap.
Beastie Rap. The game of Beastie Rap. You know that band from the 80s that stole their rhyme scheme from another band from the 80s? Well, the Beastie Boys had a rhyme scheme that went like this. They would set up a rhyme, and then the group would finish it together. So we're going to do that with your names back and forth until they hesitate to repeat themselves, until which they will rotate. So let us start with a single-syllable name. Yes, you.
Dan.
That's right. Dan. Dan is a single-syllable name. Brad, you'll initiate. Players, are you ready?
Yes.
This is Beastie Rap Begin.
Let's lay down thick like
whole milk, bop-ba-sh-ba-da-ba-da.
I know this guy, his name is
Dan. Bop-ba-sh-ba-da-ba-da.
I fry an egg with a
pan. Bop-ba-sh-ba-da-ba-da.
I've been pulling up to my friend's house in a
van. Bop-ba-sh-ba-da-ba-da.
It's not a girl, it's a
man. Bop-ba-sh-ba-da-ba-da.
I'm laying on the beach to get a
tan. Bop-ba-sh-ba-da-ba-da.
I drink my milk from a
can.
It is feels super confident. Also, canned milk sounds disgusting.
is also called a
hair bomb.
I've got a
bad bumper sputter butter.
It's past tense of snot. It's
snap.
I think I'm actually starting to get the hang of this.
Yeah, yeah. Fives, right?
Yeah. Kind of hard for me. According to my calculations, we have a score of 10 to 10.
Hey! All right, guys! That is our score for this first half. But before we go, give a big round of applause for our visiting Palace Mayonnaise players! Sports Live to see me and other people my age don the red and the blue and perform these games. If you ever need a weekend night where you need to take the whole family out, it's a great place to go to come check out. And like I said, we have a lot of really talented people who came out of comedy sports, like Chris Tallman. Wayne Brady was a comedy sports player for a really long time. So you're going to get quality entertainment. You head on up to North Hollywood, check out the comedy sports show over at the El Portal Theater. That is my shameless plugging for our theater. And now, the moment you've been waiting for, let's welcome our players!
All right, from PV, we have AJ El Doggo Holic. Up next, we have Abby Honest Abe Mohadez. Thirdly, we have Patty Esteban Julio. And finally, PV's team captain, Alex Gigi Patton. Now let's meet our players from your alma mater, Mira, Costa. Up first, we have Molly Sunny DeSimone. Next, we have
have Stephanie, Chips, and Sala. After that, we have Jack, not a fooder, but a drinker. And finally, the team captain for Mira Costa, Emma, elbows, but knee rag.
Take your order. May I take your order?
begin.
Once said, math is math. So I think I can follow that by saying we have a score of Mira Costa 15, PV 10.
Yeah, pretty innocent. we went back in time with this place.
We
pretty
long
weird.
Ago.
We weren't at a castle, if that's what you're saying.
We weren't.
Walmart.
You weren't in a moat? You know,
maybe.
It's not where you were, it's what you did.
No, it's really, it's what you did.
Pitiful. I'm surprised you fit a boat in this place. Come on. What? In a body of water?
Swimming? We weren't sailing. That's
some hands in use.
There's a lot of falling around.
We weren't kayaking.
We pulled.
We were water skiing.
Hey! Yeah. 2.5 minutes.
You were.
But who you did this with
is the real issue.
Reminds me of my favorite number.
44.
We were legendary.
Legend.
Some might say
an
icon.
Jackie Robinson.
No.
A different legend.
More recent. This wasn't 44 years ago, kids.
Stop telling your white lies.
The circus!
Round 10.
The Declaration of Independence.
We will start with that one. Players, are you ready?
Yes!
This is Four Square Begin!
Martha?
Yeah?
I'm gonna steal it.
Dr. Vet Carson, I think you should have stayed a surgeon. Why did you invite me to the moon with you?
I thought it'd be a fun time.
No! This is awful.
Rotate.
Welcome to Ringling Brothers, Barnum and Bailey.
I was just wondering about the elephants. I just wanted to know what conditions they were living in.
I'm so sorry. I had no idea.
Martha!
I had no idea it was Sharpie. I'm so sorry.
Oh, this document is hundreds of years old and you write on it with a Sharpie. A Sharpie, Martha.
I'm sorry, Nicholas Cage. Don't yell at me.
Okay.
Dr. Ben Carson, your scalpel accidentally went into my tubular astro tube that helped me breathe.
Oh, no, you have 3 minutes until you die. I swear, doctor.
Rotate.
So, do you have any other reason, or are you just kind of pass about the elephants? They're really not that exciting.
Well, I mean, I'm totally not undercover writing an article for the New York Times.
Are you for PETA?
Rotate.
You know what? We're gonna trace it.
Rotate.
Right there. I used my TI-84 special calculator. I got 2 million, so I went back and I did it again. And I have Mira Costa 18, PV 15.
Scene at any point, I can do anything that that you can do with the DVD remote. Change languages, change scenes, fast forward, reverse, AV, repeat, Spanish, all of that fun stuff. So, we will get the title of the movie, but I'm going to do it in a special way. Give a lady, just think of an adjective, not yet, don't tell me yet. This isn't a magic trick, but, and think of a noun, okay? What is your adjective? Okay, and what's your noun? The hard guitar. The hard guitar is the name of this movie. It really does. Players, are you ready?
Yeah!
You have 4 minutes, begin. Chapter one, play.
Meow, 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 meow. Oh, this is so hardcore.
Thanks, Mr. Manager.
French.
S'il vous plaît, je
m'appelle. Je m'appelle. Je vais à guitare.
Ah, comment ça va?
English.
You're very, very good at this. Oh, thank you. I just started off being hardcore, but you know, maybe I can go on to better things.
You're 12, kid. I can take you places.
Really?
I can take you far in this business. I know a thing or two.
Fast forward 3 chapters.
I love you, Argentina! Guys, that was
great show.
That was
great show.
Such a good show.
Guys, I'm really sorry, but I have math homework I gotta do. I can't.
Yeah.
Alternate angle.
Sorry, guys. I got math homework too. I can't.
Regular angle.
Yeah, it's just pre-algebra. It's just a really hard subject.
Can't forget. Keep getting held back.
14 arguments
wrong. No. I guess that's just me, Lil Jimmy.
Fast forward. 2 chapters.
Jessica, I know that we've known each other for only a little bit while now, and I'm always a
little bit while now.
But.
Whoa, I know I'm your manager and...
Slow motion.
I'm your manager, but I'm only 17. Oh, yeah!
Pause. What? Regular speed.
Yes, I'll do it. Yes, I'll do it.
Fast forward to... No, wait, I want to see what this guy's
going to
do.
Marry you?
I just got my marriage license.
Fast forward 2 chapters.
Here comes the bride.
But 2 chapters to marry them?
Here comes the bride.
German.
Spiegel Schnitzel.
Fast forward to the dramatic conclusion.
Jessica, I know that you're going to Argentina soon, and I can't go with you, but maybe we can make long distance work, you know?
So you're picking the band over me?
What?
Cut to the alternate ending.
You know what? Screw Argentina. I'm coming with you. I'm going to be your manager forever.
Cut to the very unpopular third ending.
So, you're kind of boring. We've been manager alone for like 4 years now. Argentina seems like 10 times better. So I'm going to go. So.
It sucks. It's quit. Quit the band.
Johnson.
I don't know how to use geometry, but what I do know is how to count by fives. The score is PV 20, Mira Costa 18.
Every time they make a successful joke, they will get a point. Players, are you ready?
Yes!
Begin!
Oh, let me just get it the heel out of here.
Hey, waiter, there's a sock in my suit.
Oh, I guess we got off on the wrong foot, huh?
I'll just handle that.
Hey, waiter, there's a sock in my suit.
Just shoo it away, it sometimes works.
Hey, waiter, there's a sock in my suit.
Oh, no, that's just the fruit of the loom.
Sock with it.
There's a sock in my suit.
Oh, yeah, it's got lots of pears.
Hey, waiter, there's a sock in my suit.
Well, knee high to you, too.
Hey, waiter, there's a sock in my suit.
Well, I lost the other one in the dryer, so.
Hey, waiter, there's a sock in my suit.
Lint, me help you with that.
Hey, waiter, there's a sock in my suit.
Well, you obviously have no soul. You have a soul,
Mary.
All right. Let us get an alive thing.
A baby.
Right. But I'll do that too. But a mop. Hey, waiter, there's a mop in my suit. This looks like you shouting. Begin.
Sorry, is that bugging you?
Hey, waiter, there's a moth in my suit.
Oh, yeah, let me just... Oh, a bright light! Oh!
Hey, waiter, there's a moth in my suit.
Yeah, it's moth so ball soup.
Oh, I gotta fly.
Hey, waiter, there's a baby in my suit. Alive, one.
Final score of 33, we have...